what this whole concept is I call them the underground strength sessions. And the reason I started doing this a couple years ago was I wanted to be able to pull all my sponsor guys together to let them learn from each other. You know, they may be the top dog in their gym. You know, so I can bring them here with other strong guys so they can learn from each other, correspond with each other, get to know each other, because I'm trying to build an actual team. There's prices that you gotta pay, and that is just the way it is. And I'm telling it as it is, it still isn't gonna make any difference. It's no different than when I was 20 years old, I remember sitting at a dinner table, and I had a master's power lifter sitting right there with me saying, look dude, you need to quit doing some of this stupid shit you're doing. Otherwise, you're gonna be fucked up before you're 40, okay? I'm 20 years old, I've never had an injury. Fuck you, you don't know what the hell you're talking about. All right, now I'm that dude. And I'm sitting there and I'm talking to those other guys. You know, at the same time, I realize they ain't gonna fucking listen to me. But the real cool thing about this is, in the gym, everybody's equal.
When you have like 5 or 6 guys who can squat 1,000 pounds, you know, ice is bound to be necessary at some point. But I'm not thinking about that. I'm just thinking right now, will they make me lift with the girls? That's my only worry right now.
I don't know if you can define success. I think that's a personal definition. But what I do know is passion is huge. You know, passion is the number one thing. You have to be passionate about what you're gonna do and what you're doing. When you have aim and you have focus on something, all right, you're gonna be 100% committed for that and nothing is gonna stop you. But the one thing that's constant is passion. Passion has to be there because passion's the thing that fucking trumps everything.
Dave has 365 pounds on an SS yoke bar. Surrounding him in his warehouse gym is a dozen of the world's strongest men. Men who squat a grand, deadlift 800, and bench 700. Dave has squatted 935 pounds, benched 610, and deadlifted 740. He's reached elite status in 4 different weight classes. But 30 pec strains and two torn pecs, numerous overuse injuries, several shoulder surgeries, a torn teres major, torn groin, multiple herniated discs, a tendon tear in his knee, and both calves ripped completely in half, and this is just a partial list, have taken their toll on him. How far will Dave take this? Maybe he's thinking of the bully who hit him in the mouth with a ball bat when he was a kid, knocking out a tooth. That's when he withdrew, went inside, started lifting weights, building what he described as a suit of armor to keep people out and away. Maybe he's thinking of what he calls his dark time, the time where in the midst of depression, he drove to a Walmart and sat in the parking lot, wondering if he'd be able to buy a gun and end the pain. But maybe Dave's thinking of another time, when he wrote in his journal, "I made a change that day. I no longer wanted to live my life carrying a heavy suit of armor, and the armor was peeled off, one piece at a time." Even though the film crew didn't catch his 31st rep, looking like a black-hooded grim reaper coming out of the tomb, Dave unracks the bar and begins grinding out five additional reps for a total of 35.
Go, Dave.
His personal demons may not be destroyed yet, but he has them tamed. They work for him these days. We all have our demons. The question is, do they control you, or do you control them?
Don't fear the reaper, nor do the wind, the sun, or the rain.
We can be like they are.
Come on, baby,
don't fear the reaper.
Baby, take my